Hello everyone, I'm Devin Pellicone, Manager of Product Development here at Advanced Cooling Technologies. This is part four, our final part of our four-part series on data center cooling technologies, where today we're going to be talking about the different types of immersion cooling. If you haven't seen our previous three videos, please go and check those out. They talk about different direct-to-chip liquid cooling and system-level cooling techniques for data centers. So today we're talking about single-phase and two-phase immersion cooling, which is a very different type of cooling than the direct-to-chip and air cooling technologies we talked about previously. The concept here is relatively simple. Instead of having cold plates and blowing air across the server, we take the entire server and submerge it in a bath of a different type of fluid. For single-phase immersion techniques, these fluids tend to be oils. They're dielectric, and so you can put the entire electronic equipment inside of this fluid and it doesn't short anything out. In a single-phase immersion technique, as the name suggests, the fluid is single phase. So there's no boiling, the fluid circulates through the system, slightly pump assisted, and cools down the servers from the system. So this is what an immersion tank may look like in a single phase system. It's supported by a pump and a heat exchanger elsewhere in the system. Typically, these tanks have some sort of a perforated plate at the bottom of the tank, and what you might consider as a weir at the top of the tank. So the fluid is pumped into the perforated plate at the bottom of the tank and distributed up into all of the server blades. They're typically mounted vertically inside of this tank. That fluid very slowly moves up through all of the servers, picking up the heat from all of the electronics, and then overflows out of the tank where it's collected and distributed to an ultimate heat exchanger that rejects that heat to ambient. And then that can be pumped around the system again. So it's an open system, so the tank is open typically at the top where you can make all of your electrical connections and you can service these systems if you need to. And that oil is just kind of very slowly circulated through the system. And that's how a single phase immersion technology absorbs the heat. In two phase, it's a little bit similar, except for the fact that in this case, we allow the fluid to boil. So these are sealed tanks, so they typically are not open to the atmosphere. They have a working fluid inside of them that's also dielectric, but in this case, the heat that is picked up from the servers boils the fluid. And so we generate bubbles inside of this tank everywhere, vapor bubbles. And those vapor bubbles are collected up at a condenser that is cooled. So the vapor travels up, it is condensed where it rejects the heat, and the liquid falls back down into the tank. So you have this natural circulation that happens inside of the tank. It's two-phase. You're rejecting a lot of heat off of these servers because you're boiling that fluid, which absorbs a lot of heat in the latent heat. And then these condensers are typically serviced by a very similar system to what we have over here. It's a pumped liquid loop. We pump a coolant into this heat exchanger. It's colder than the fluid is, and so we can condense the vapor and allow this system to operate. So these are the principles of what we would consider immersion technologies. They're relatively new to the marketplace, and they can dissipate large amounts of heat. That's it for our four-part series on data center cooling. If you'd like more information, you can always visit our website at one-act.com. Thanks.